As promised, welcome back to Sports Talk as Corey approves of my music choice.
Every time we come back from break, I'm like, he gets it.
I don't do a Nassau mix here no more, so I got to show off the taste in some way.
My naysayer.
You know what I mean? I'm happy you saw that clip. Oh, I actually kind of want to get to that now.
To naysayer, please, yeah, like I was doing.
Yeah, right. The guys on College Game, they had a little fun today.
Hey, yo, Pat McAfee is making his money.
Oh, man.
I'm telling you, that's about to be the word. He just earned Jalen Milroe some money. Whoever about to trademark naysayer about to get a lot of bread.
No, the delivery was like Reese Davis on the ESPN. We're going to pull up the audio in a little bit. Yo, the delivery. He had me shook for a split. I'm like, oh, naysayer.
I'm like, I'm Pat, you caught that? Pat might be on the sub.
But I love that Pat was the first one to catch it, too. Oh, man. Welcome back to Sports Talk. Joshua Yamahi, Kory David, Liam Flynn, Ross Levine, and you at 516-572-7440. Yeah, so like Corey, just to let everyone know what we're talking about, College Game Day was on. Obviously, they're previewing the college football playoff, the two games, the Sugar Bowl and the Rose Bowl tonight. So Reese Davis is talking about Jalen Milroe and Alabama. The Crimson Tide have had this saying, LANK, all season long. You've heard LANK since they struggled early in the season, lost that game to Texas early on in the season. So here's Reese Davis explaining the meaning of LANK.
Often wears his own branded apparel reading LANK across the front. It's an acronym that stands for Let a Naysayer Know. Being told by his former offensive coordinator, Bill O'Brien.
That is not what I thought.
Is that not what you thought?
Boy, let a naysayer know.
Let a naysayer know.
Of course.
The professional's right in the middle of his knee. That's all right. I just keep going.
You almost lost me. Yeah. Hey,
Ray. It got real tight up here.
It got real tight up here.
Oh, right.
Pause. Yeah.
But, yo. The way he just flowed into that, he had me shook. Let a naysayer know.
Hard R, too. Not even didn't even throw a naysayer up there.
Tell me, you know the funniest thing? Like, I seen somebody had posted it. Like, you remember it was like a while ago, like a teacher? There was a teacher. It's like, can a naysayer borrow a pencil? And you remember the Boondocks did a skit on it? I said, naysayer, and naysayer.
You had the two pieces
two
of paper?
Two different words.
I put an A-H at the end. Yeah. Naysayer.
Naysayer, please.
Naysayer, can I borrow a pencil?
Naysayers in Paris.
Well, I don't know if you can say naysayers.
Oh, naysayers?
Yeah, naysayers is cool.
I ain't go for you. Right. You
can't throw no hard R.
My bad. I was the one who just said it.
Look.
He's like, he threw out the hard R.
Josh, I'm scared of that word a little bit now.
Naysayers?
Because they going to find a way. People going to find a way of getting around the word. Yeah.
You know that Drewski skill of Alabama? What did he say?
I don't like them naysayers.
I don't like them naysayers that don't doubt the tide. It's all about the tide, baby. Don't get pissed about nothing but the tide.
Roll tide, baby. Roll tide. I go for
Oh, man.
We getting into the college football tonight, right now?
We went in a little bit, but, it's Monday, Corey. You know what time it is?
Wait, I thought this... You use this for this is our music. This is Friday's music. Yeah.
But it's multi-purpose. We can do it to recap the weekend's action as well, bro.
It's Friday. This Monday life is different.
Monday life is different. This is the NFL weekend recap for week 17. We of course got to start local. We are contractually obligated to talk about the New York Giants.
Yes, the missed kick. You legend, Mason Crosby.
I'm not gonna
thank
lie.
You.
Why didn't we put Tyrod Taylor in earlier? Like
what?
In the middle of the season?
Oh,
Ross,
Corey wants to win games.
No. I'm not saying to win.
I get it. I understand.
No, I'm not saying to win games. I'm saying we would have never had Tommy DeVito in. It would have helped our draft stock tremendously.
So you think Tyrod Taylor's losing some of those games that DeVito won? Taylor's a better quarterback.
I don't know. Did you see that 2-point conversion to Barkley? I don't know. That was a little.
That was bad. We know how to make it look convinced. We got to make it look convinced.
I think that before that kick field goal, those little runs, I think Joe Shane literally, like, there's a little tiny Joe Shane and Brian Dable's brain telling him, hey, let's be the dumbest play calls now. We need to lose this game. So let's have a little Joe Shane.
No, it's a little whisper like Drake, man.
Yeah, exactly, right?
If Tommy DeVito was in that game, I bet you he would have won just to get a couple more minutes of clout.
You heard the Giants crowd chanting DeVito. DeVito.
Yeah, that was just his whole family. That wasn't even the Giants fans.
That's true. Got a big family. The Italian Stallion.
Yeah, the five families. The Giants right now have the 5th overall pick in the draft. So they would be losing out on Caleb Williams, Drake May, and Jaden Daniels by the looks of this.
Tommy DeVito.
Yeah.
Why'd you have to win 4 games?
I know.
He had a lot of naysayers and no.
I'm pissed off about it. I don't know why we had to win, but Giants fans that went to the game wanted them to win. I don't understand.
Why we couldn't get Trevor Siemian? Well, we couldn't have trouble.
All right, enough.
Tim
enough,
Boyle?
Enough
make, Tim Boyle?
Enough make quarterback talk. I'm done. Enough. Tyrod Taylor, 319 pass yards, a touchdown, and a pick. Missed that 2-point conversion to Barkley, but had that long touchdown pass to Darius Slayton. Wink Martindale and the Giants defense did a decent job on Matt Stafford, forced him into 2 picks, but Puka Nacua.
Yeah, buddy. Puka Nacua.
As Liam celebrates his fantasy team won the championship.
Yes, Antonio. Where's the money?
Yeah, he got to show you that cash. Don't let the fact that he left keep you from getting your money.
No, I know. I'm waiting for the when I get that the Miller Lite cheers to a victory animation on the app when I open it. I'm waiting for the confetti to roll down before I get that. So once it's officially official, I will be pounding at his door.
Yes,
to try and get that money, because
like a bill collector.
Yeah, I got to go to Applebee's. Got to get the whole spread of 4 appetizers.
Are they still doing the Dollaritas at
I don't know, maybe.
Yeah, get yourself some Dollaritas with
I'm just a Coke guy. I'm 19, Josh.
I'm sorry.
I'm underage.
Everyone's not over 21 like the rest of us in the room.
Oh, yeah, I'm the only one.
Yeah.
You guys can go get some Dollaritas, though, on me, because I won the championship.
There we go. Puka Nacua, helping Liam's fantasy team out. 5 catches, 188 yards. The Rams clinched a playoff spot. They're locked into the NFC 6th seed. If the standings hold, they play the Dallas Cowboys in the first round.
Can I just say, though, that ruined my week. That awful call. The NFL should be ashamed of themselves. They really should. That was a travesty how that game ended.
Let's get to it right now. The Rams did beat the Giants 26-25.
Good.
The Dallas Cowboys 11-5. They survived and secured an undefeated 8-0 record at home. But like Ross said, Dan Campbell and the Lions score a touchdown, make it 20-19. They go for 2. They have and this is where the ineligible receiver stuff comes in.
Yeah.
They have a 2-point conversion to Taylor Decker, offensive lineman. There's no flags on the field for like a minute.
Mm-hmm. I know.
Then the referee suddenly comes together. Ineligible receiver.
Hey, my parlay wasn't hitting right. Yo, right. We're going to run that back.
How you think I felt? I had Lions live money line up plus 600. That could have been a great New Year's gift.
Jerry Jones, man, he paid the refs. We all know it.
I want me some glory hoe.
And then you have Cowboys fans that's like, oh, no, it's not the refs. No, it is absolutely the refs. They had a 2-point conversion. It was in the end zone. They would have taken the lead with 23 seconds left to play. Now, Dallas may have, went down the field and got a game-winning field, but I would have liked to see what would have happened there. But of course, one of the dumbest officials, Brad Allen. Has to step in and affect the game. Shame on you, NFL. Shame on you.
It's the ref show.
It is.
Welcome to the ref show, ladies and gentlemen. Brad Allen, like Ross said, just out of nowhere, this ineligible receiver.
Yeah.
You see the video, Taylor Decker and another offensive lineman go walk over to Allen, and it's like, what do you think they could be talking about? What, dinner plans?
Yeah.
No, he's telling you, I'm walking over to you to let you know, I'm an eligible receiver on the play.
Yeah.
I don't know how that happens, but.
And apparently they got him mixed up.
Oh, right.
They thought forget which number was who, but they thought number 68.
58?
It was 68 and 70, I think.
Yeah, 68 and 70.
I get I get that it was so wrong that they called that touchdown back, but the Lions were trying to be sneaky. Yeah. They had I'm trying to remember the offensive lineman name.
Penae Sewell.
I'm getting my Polynesian names mixed up. But no, they had all three linemen out there. They was basically trying to disguise it because, mind you, you had 68, you had 58. It was kind of like they were trying to be sneaky with it.
But even if that's true, if a refereeing crew is getting confused, that's not a good look.
Yeah, the numbers are there for a reason.
Another thing I'm confused at, aren't they supposed to call out, like, number 68 is eligible, number 70 is eligible?
No, they did.
They got it mixed up
between number 68 and number 70. Because number 68 and number 70 both walked over.
Did they only rule one eligible or both eligible?
They said one was eligible.
Only one. Well, I think both were trying to be ineligible.
No, but I think one was just trying to be eligible, and they both walked over as a team. Because they're teammates, you know?
What happened was that they said, like, you're good. You're good. You're fine being on the field. And then when the play happened and it was over, it was like, no, it wasn't good. That's what it's basically like saying you take a test in high school, right? And the A is the correct answer, and you circle A, and then they say it's wrong. That's what happened with the officials. That's how stupid the NFL was that day.
Like I always say, we got to check these officials' FanDuel, but the Cowboys did win. They can clinch the NFC East with a win on Sunday versus the Commanders. Moving on, the San Francisco 49ers are the number one seed in the NFC. They got a big road win at the aforementioned Commanders. Brock Purdy bounced back, 2 touchdown passes. Niners clinched number one seed because the Philadelphia Eagles lost their 4th game in the last 5. This time to former defensive coordinator for the Super Bowl run last year, Jonathan Gannon, and Kyler Murray outplaying Jalen Hurts. And Arizona wins in Philadelphia 35-31.
The Philadelphia's corners are garbaggio. And that includes James Bradbury, the former Giant. You stink, buddy. You stink. Thank you, Joe Shane, for letting me
go. Did you ever see that picture of like a kid? I think it was somebody who had like two trash cans and they had both their names on it.
Oh, yeah. And by the way, potentially the future Giants quarterback, Kyle Murray. A little outside the box thinking.
Here's the thing, though.
I knew we won better. Giants country. That's right.
Russell, that's disgusting.
No.
Broncos country. That's right.
That's disgusting.
Imagine that.
That's gross.
I'm telling you.
Where's the toilet?
To be fair, you know what? He did win a Super Bowl at MetLife. So he's won some big games there.
I guess.
He was coming along during the season.
Yeah.
He did have a.
They went on like a 4 or 5 game winning streak, right?
Yeah.
Come on now.
Sierra in Jersey. I don't know if she likes
Sierra in Jersey?
Yeah.
Get her in West Caldwell or something. She had no idea that she's in Jersey.
There's
some nicer areas. There are pockets, but.
That's a great point.
Keep her out of Elizabeth. It stinks.
Oh, Elizabeth? Yeah.
Elizabeth just smells bad.
Stay away from Elizabeth. That's great advice from Liam. Like I said, the Cardinals won. Eagles drop to 11-5. If they win and Dallas loses, they'll be a 2 seed. But I mean, I don't think anybody's taking them seriously at this point. The Bucks and the Saints. Bucks had a chance at the NFC South title, but the New Orleans Saints won. They're the funniest team in the league.
Question: Why did the Saints win?
Because you called it.
No.
Why?
Because they put the ball in the hands of the GOAT, Taysom Hill, TD. Can't be stopped.
And your Saints are winning the division.
No.
Oh, yeah, you so are.
No, I mean, it don't matter anyway because Dennis Allen's coming back. No. So,
yeah.
Yeah, so but you at least have something to play for. That's the difference. You have a chance to get a home playoff game in Mercedes-Benz.
You know what, though? If we play the Eagles.
I think you're going to win.
Might have a pass, for you. Josh. Come on.
I'm rooting for
you. Y'all can do you know how you counter the tush push? You got one on. You do it on for the Saints. Only thing is, you put Taysom Hill at QB.
Yeah.
Touchdown, automatic.
Yo, every time Taysom Hill scores, Corey stands up at the TV. That's how a white man runs the football. Like in that.
What? One second. No, because guess what? He don't just run. He catches. He passes.
Yeah.
He could kick.
He can do it all.
He can play defense. He can do it all. He like the modern day Booby Miles.
You think he runs like a naysayer?
Better sometimes.
Better. Wow. Okay.
Look. Guess what? Whatever you paying Alvin Kamara.
Too far. Baker Mayfield came in red hot, passed for over 300 yards, but most of that came in garbage time. Derek Carr looked good. Two touchdowns, no turnovers. Bucks can still clinch the division with a win against the 2-14 Carolina Panthers.
Josh, quick question.
Yeah.
What's Michael Thomas doing? Just at the house, just chilling, just on Twitter every time they play?
Definitely on Twitter. Bricks. Yeah. Getting into some trouble.
Yeah.
Mischievous, that one.
Hey, I seen that Jonathan Abrams interception.
Yeah. It's like you see certain players make plays. It's like, what year is this?
I was like, I had to search him up. I'm like, wait, who is this? I feel like I know this person. Like,
Jonathan Abrams?
I'm like, then I looked up, yo, he was on the Raiders. I'm like, they literally let him wear Charles Woodson number. That's a shame.
Shameful. Lamar Jackson. So we have an analyst by the name, a woman by the name of Montbellanos.
He's very quarterbacky.
Yeah, she said Lamar Jackson wasn't the MVP because he wasn't quarterbacky enough. She said she likes her quarterbacks to be quarterbacky.
What?
Is 5 touchdowns and 3 incompletions quarterbacky enough for you? Because that's what Lamar Jackson did 18, to clinch the one seed yesterday.
18 for 21.
Perfect passer rating. Third time in his career, perfect passer rating. You know, quarterbacky.
You know the last time he did that? It was against the Miami Dolphins.
in 2019. So Lamar Jackson from that area.
He always look. Whenever he go up against Miami, he's just, I just got to get him.
Lamar Jackson, man, clinched the MVP yesterday, we think. Pretty much, right?
Yeah, I would say so.
Not in Richard Sherman's eyes. Richard Sherman says it don't change nothing for me. Christian McCaffrey is still MVP.
Well, Lamar Jackson let that naysayer know yesterday. I don't know what to tell you. Lamar Jackson's the MVP.
I don't know if he's the MVP, but I'm not going to lie. I'm scared for that. I'm scared for the Baltimore Ravens.
I would be very disappointed if it's not Ravens Niners.
Me too. Yeah, look, I'm going to tell you right now. Don't get your hopes up. Don't get your hopes up. I can see a situation where...
Who's going to walk into Baltimore and beat the Ravens? In the AFC. The mid-ass AFC this season.
I mean, the Tennessee Titans did it a couple years ago. Are we just not going to forget
that's
that?
True.
Walking your trap and taking over your trap.
That's a different Lamar Jackson. That's a different Ravens team.
But here's what I'll say, though. Lamar's got to do in the playoffs. He is not.
That's and then true. He has one playoff win. That's fair.
And you also got to take on the fact that the Ravens are having a lot of injuries. A lot of injuries.
That's true.
Hopefully they can get Mark Andrews back to the playoffs.
Isaiah Likely, though, 2 touchdowns. He's filling in pretty well.
But it's highly unlikely. See what I was about to set up there?
Huh. There's no way. What drop can I play for that one? I don't even know what I got. That's so bad. I don't even know what to
give me the drums.
From.
Give me the drum sound.
Nah, you don't even deserve that. That was terrible.
That was all right. It was all right.
Just you got to give it. Come on, give him the rim shot.
What?
That's what it's called. That's what
don't
it's called.
Don't give me that.
Yo! Josh, go into the retro beds quick start channel. Go into retro beds.
Yes.
And then we got it right there. Rim shot.
We just have to change it to the drum shot.
Nah,
you change it to the drum shot.
It's called a rim shot. I'm just saying. Don't shoot the messenger now.
Sports, please. Josh Allen struggled against the Patriots. Bills won. The Bills are one win away from an AFC East title. They went from 6-6. They can win the AFC East.
I'm calling for justice for somebody. Justice for Stephon Diggs. This man can't score a touchdown. Every time I have him on my parlays.
Of course.
Josh.
Of course. Your parlay.
Allen better get it done the next time. I'm going to say. Otherwise... Giant.
Josh Allen.
If he doesn't get it done in the next couple of years.
Hey, I see the vision.
By then.
I see the vision.
Yeah. I'm just saying Brian Daboll.
No, Corey can't say that.
I'm saying just Brian Daboll. That's it.
Corey can't say that. No, you used to say, we have Josh Allen at home. We got Daniel Jones.
Daniel Jones sucks.
I'm not taking that from you.
Oh, yeah, I did say that.
That's like getting Purdue when you're asking for McNuggets.
But wait, we can get... look. We're talking about... It's like we could get the name brand version now. You can finally get the name brand version. Come on.
Let's be real. It's a pipe dream. I'm just, again,
but
Brian Daboll.
Here's the thing, right? If Josh Allen isn't able to get it done now, who says he's going to be able to get it done later without Stephon Diggs?
Cool question. What would you have thought if the Giants would have gave up 2 first rounds and gave Lamar Jackson whatever he wanted?
I'd rather have Lamar than what we got right now.
Because every time somebody says, like, oh, the Ravens wouldn't have given up Lamar, I'm like, the Texans gave Deshaun Watson.
Right.
It can happen.
Who?
That man who's not better than Joe Flacco.
Flacco is...
We almost went a whole show without his name being mentioned.
Flacco's the man.
Flacco's the man. Yo, you got people from the... You got people from... on the Jets team talking about, hey, go win a chip for my city. Like...
Joe Flacco.
Oh, my God.
Joe Flacco. A second.
Elite.
You stole...
What?
You stole it from me.
Come on, that's like the first thing you got to say. I waited to throw that out. We're talking about Joe Flacco for like 15 seconds. Usually it's like the third or fourth second. You're like, elite.
You got to be quicker than that.
Yeah.
Got to be quicker than that.
Exactly.
Is that the Geico commercial?
Yep. Just to wrap up the weekend recap real quick, no losing seasons for Mike Tomlin.
We do not care.
He don't care if he's got Mason Rudolph as his quarterback. They've won two straight there, 9-7. They can clinch. No, they can't. Well, we'll get into all the clinching scenarios in a little bit.
I really wish you had a LeVar never lost in there.
I'm pretty sure I do. I'll go look for it. C.J. Stroud came back. Texans crushed the Titans. It's a three-way tie atop the AFC South. Colts, Texans, and the brain freeze Jaguars, all 9-7.
You mean that team that can't afford a cart?
For Trevor Lawrence, right. Yeah, that'll about do it. The Packers destroyed the Vikings. They had Jair Alexander's back, it turned out.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah. Shout out to Justin Fields, because he beat the Falcons. Justin Fields had a rushing touchdown, a passing touchdown. He might be the Bears quarterback to stay.
Yeah. Whoa.
Who needs Caleb Williams when you got Justin Fields?
I don't know about that.
You heard the Bears crowd chant Justin Fields. Like they want him as their quarterback. They don't want Caleb Williams. Yeah.
Then we know why the Bears will never win anything.
They're not going to win anything with Caleb. He's not winning anything.
I think Justin Fields might need a position change.
You're saying he's not quarterbacky enough?
He definitely not.
Fields.
What?
Fields, come on. You Fields?
Have you seen how he's been playing lately?
Fields
two games. You know what? Two games will give you a big sample.
Bucket 4:56 January 1st, Monday. Bears beating the Packers, knocking them out the playoffs next week.
Okay. I do want to give a shout out.
Guarantee.
Shout out to Nassau Community College's own Rasul Douglas for two interceptions and a TD.
We show our alums love here on Sports Talk.
I haven't heard you mention Ian Thomas not one time for the Carolina Panthers.
See, you answered your own question, because the Carolina Panthers don't get no love on my show. They don't get no love when I host. That just don't happen. It'll never happen. Oh, they're 2-14 though. They clinched the number one pick, but for
no, they don't. The Bears. So, which at this point, do you get Marvin Harrison Jr.?
I think the Bears.
I think so.
I think Fields. I know he's playing great. I still think they're going to move on. I think he's going to be a Jet. I think Fields. I that's my theory. I think Fields is going to get traded to the Jets.
Why would you wish that? Why would you wish that on?
Think about it. Rodgers is going to retire after next year.
No, he's not. He's saying he's going to have a couple more years.
He's saying that now.
So you replace Zach Wilson for worse than Zach Wilson.
No, I'd say
that Justin Fields is better than Zach Wilson, but like they're the complete opposite.
I say Zach Wilson is a better passer. I say Fields is a better runner, a better athlete.
But Fields is special. Like there's something. He's a project. He's a project quarterback. Fields. He's like it's like you're buying like an old 1950s car with a broken down engine. You can rebuild it. Right. The body's there. It looks beautiful. Just got to rebuild it, put some time into it.
Pause, but he's more like the boyfriend that when the girl says, I can fix him, and it never works.
real quick, we got a couple minutes left in the show. Who we got in the national championship? Bama, Michigan, Texas, Washington tonight in the Rose Bowl and Sugar Bowl, respectively.
Give me Michigan.
Michigan and?
Give me Washington.
Michigan and Washington. Liam, what you say?
Washington, Alabama.
I'll go Alabama-Texas. I want that revenge game factor from early in the season.
I'll go Alabama and Washington.
I like it.
The only reason why I say Michigan is because people forget that Jalen Milroe got benched like early in the season. Like
I know.
And they almost lost to Auburn, who lost to New Mexico State.
But did you see that conference room when Michigan was sitting there and they announced that they were playing Alabama? They were like,
They're more scared of Alabama's defense, offensive line, and running back. They look at the quarterback situation like, we can do something with that.
Yeah, that's the only thing.
As we wrap up sports talk today, the Knicks, like we've been following along after the OG Anunoby trade, they're up 94-78 on the Timberwolves. OG Anunoby, a team high plus 29 in his debut. So. And Corey, I found it.
I'm undefeated, never lost.
Looks like the Knicks is going to be undefeated in the OG Anunoby era. But we know the Knicks can blow a lead, so.
Yeah.
Don't quote me on that.
Tell me why I had money on the Pistons and finally they lost. Oh, I mean, they finally won. And my parlay didn't hit.
Of course. A parlay failed to close the show for Kory David. That'll do it for Sports Talk today. Thank you on behalf of Ross Levine, Kory David, Liam Flynn, and myself, Joshua Yamahi, for listening to Sports Talk here on the Voice of Nassau Community College, 90.3 WHPC. Happy New Year.